Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to TCB 30 live from the Salisbury Center. Fight number two is coming up right now. Let's throw it down to Chris Fuller. Take it away, Chris.
Salisbury Center, we are ready for our next fight. Making his way to the ring and fighting out of the red corner, it's Guillermo Caro.
Guillermo Caro, he's 5'9", fighting out of Juniper Muay Thai as he makes his way down here tonight. Now, as we start to ramp up the card, we talked about this going out and going into the last break, is that we get further down the card. Now, we have two titles tonight, which are co-main and main events that everybody's going to want to stick around for. I saw the weigh-ins last night. Those guys look serious. They're in the pictures.
Yeah. Raekwon Turner, we've seen him fight quite a few times now. And, I mean, the guy is just incredibly talented. Also, he's like 6'3" at 155 pounds, which is just out of this world. I mean, that's like unheard of to be that tall and that light, you know. And he knows how to use it. He's got great kicks. When he lets his hands go, they're very dangerous and very crisp. And all those guys over there at Capital MMA and Fitness, it's just such a strong kickboxing pedigree between Atif and Connor Mosby and Raekwon Turner, and that their whole team really is just something else. And I believe Guillermo, by the way, is choosing not to walk out to music. He's walking out to silence, which there's a part of me that respects that.
Yeah, or give us a warning.
Well, you know, Kevin likes to, for those that don't know, Kevin usually sings along as fighters are walking out. So it is a pretty cool thing here. And look, Guillermo, I believe we've seen him fight before. Real heavy leg kicks, a strong base. And you know, the guys over at Juniper Muay Thai, that's a solid gym. They know what they're doing.
All right, let's throw it down. Hang on. We're going to stand by just for a second here. I think we just want to make sure that Guillermo has everything squared away. Now, this is a little bit different when we start talking about what's happening, right? So we're going to kind of go around the ring, right? And they do some of the official or traditional Muay Thai. All right, let's throw it down to Chris Fuller. Take it away.
And his opponent, making his way to the ring and fighting out of the blue corner, it's Aimeek Chatfield.
Aimeek Chatfield, 5'6", so he's a little shorter than Guillermo, coming out of the House of Muay Thai. A little bit different, right?
So what you were saying, you know, about each fighter has their own tradition or a culture that they follow. Some guys like to just, they touch and they do a prayer in each corner. Some guys will just kind of tap in and move on. Other guys, like more usually from a kickboxing background, kind of just pace back and forth, you know, which was always what I did. But it really depends on your school's heritage and what, you know, when I say school, the gym you're training at, what they're doing there, right? Are they learning that traditional Muay Thai? Are they learning, do they have somebody over in Thailand who learned all of the things they take in that culture very, very seriously that they then brought here back to the United States and back to their home gym as well? So it really just depends on your own style and the way you were brought up.
We see that every once in a while, and at some point in time, I know maybe over in Thailand, is it a ring or is it just an area?
Usually it's a ring. So there's,
because they go across the top, they go across the top of the ring, right?
Right.
And then they go up and down in the corners on the pad. Those are the kind of things I'm like, what?
Well, believe it or not, there's actually a dance that they do.
Oh wow.
Yeah. At times there's a beat that they follow, and there's a couple different cultural things that don't always translate to Muay Thai here in the U.S. But there have been fights in the past where we've had the traditional Muay Thai music going in the background, which the idea is that it sets a pacing for the fighters to follow. That could never be me. I'm not that guy, but there are some fighters who really do quite well from it here.
Gotcha.
But we have a couple good gyms here. House of Muay Thai, we've seen them before here at TCB.
We've seen Juniper also.
Yeah, both gyms have had strong showings here, and I think this is going to be a good one.
All right, let's throw it down to Chris Fuller. Looks like we got both fighters ready to rock and roll.
Salisbury Center, this bout is scheduled for 3 2-minute rounds in the TCB 147-pound division. This is a full rules Muay Thai bout. Starting out, fighting out of the red corner, standing 5'9" and weighing in at 146 pounds, fighting out of Juniper Muay Thai, it's Guillermo Caro. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, standing 5'6" and weighing in at 147 pounds, fighting out of House of Muay Thai, it's Aimeek Chatfield. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, this bout is scheduled for 3 2-minute rounds. It is in the TCB 147-pound division, and it is brought to you by our friends at ABC Supply, America's largest wholesale distributor of roofing, siding, windows, gutters, and more. Your referee is Victor Matamala.
All right, Victor Matamala will be the referee for this one. It is scheduled for 3 2-minute rounds as we get Chris out of the ring. Now, both fighters coming in at 147 here tonight, 5'9 versus 5'6. Guillermo at 5'9 out of the red corner. He'll have the black gloves with the red tape. Aimeek fighting out of the blue corner. He's got some blue elbow pads, black gloves with that blue tape. Looks like Victor's got a little problem with what's going on with Aimeek here right off the bat. We need some more tape. We're gonna tape everything here. Looks like the elbow pad maybe there, Charles. I can't really tell.
I don't have a good look at it. Yeah, the shin
guard.
Oh,
it's the shin guard.
Yeah.
Threw me off there, Victor. Victor wants to make sure none of that's going to slide around, and it's good. There we go. Oh, somebody, we just forgot to do the whole shin guards. That's the problem. So I want to make sure those are on there. If you look, Guillermo's got white tape around those just to make sure that nothing slides down and they're protected at all times. It's Olympic-style Muay Thai, right? So no headgear for this one, right? But they are able to strike to the head.
Yeah, this is going to be pretty similar to what we just saw here from the exhibition bout, except for there is no headgear. So now I do believe that there are elbows to the head, just not knees to the head.
Victor Matamala just gave a look because I think Michael Dolman was the referee that checked out on me and didn't do a very good job. So when he goes back and listen, Victor just gave you a look, Michael. Like, do your job. Or if Adam checked, I don't know who checked him. All right, here we go. All right, Victor checks with both fighters. We check with the judges, and here we go. We're going to touch gloves right on top of the TCB logo, kind of, right? Both guys standing toe-to-toe. Ooh, really over the top here, Aimeek. Now, Aimeek looks, he says he's 5'6". Why does he look taller than Guillermo at 5'9"?
It might be he's 5'9 as well. you know, and we just have a six is just or, reversed, right?
Yeah, or they got this wrong. Ooh, good right hand.
Beautiful countering there from the from inside the clinch. But I like that those heavy underhooks that Aimeek has here. Excuse me, Aimeek. Good fight there to work that knee on the inside.
Victor's going to break him up here. Here we go. Right back to it. Couple of lefts. Ooh.
Ooh, look at that.
Yeah, elbow, right, elbow right away from Aimeek. He wants to land those elbows, do some damage.
Yeah, and that landed clean right on Guillermo there. And this is always when you are deep in on those underhooks, I always felt like it was difficult to get the knee and the torque you needed. Now, that was a good right knee that Guillermo had there, but when you're too high up and you have those hands too high, you have good control, but it's difficult to throw the knee the right way. And this is very exhausting, especially when you can tell Aimeek has got great grips and he's making Guillermo work. So while I would say I think Guillermo's stronger here and he's landing the harder shots, they're not quite as effective as the striking from Aimeek at range.
Victor breaks him up.
Ooh,
again.
Beautiful overhand right there. And then that inside elbow
Aimeek
again.
Aimeek is really trying to land the elbows. He's just bypassing these gloves right away, Charles, and he knows he's going to do more damage with the elbows.
Well, he turns it over really well. You'll see he kind of brings it forward or like it's throwing a right hand, and then he just turns that elbow right over top.
Oh, just missed right there, Guillermo, with a big right hand. About 20 seconds left to go here in round number one. Fight number two here at TCB 30.
Oh, good knee from Guillermo as well.
Just straight knees, everybody trying to get those knees in there, but it's going to be really tough for Guillermo because of the height of Aimeek, who's definitely not 5'6".
definitely not. Really interesting styles that are there. I like that elbow that Aimeek throws is dangerous, man. He's got a lot of torque on that, and it comes in sharp as ever. And for Guillermo, I think he was having good success there in the clinch. In the beginning, I thought Aimeek was doing a good job of nullifying that, but as time went on, it looked like there was some success there to be had.
Now, here we talk about different styles, and it started off really early here because Aimeek went right to the stool. Guillermo, nope, not doing it, not sitting down. I know you've told me in the past you like to sit down.
Yeah, I want to get as much air and as much relaxation as I can, and that's 60 seconds because by the time I catch my breath, it's usually already starting again, you know? So, but I will tell you, too, like, when I'm training, I don't sit down. I walk around.
Right.
It's just when there's that extra level of exertion, that stool sometimes feels like a recliner, like a lazy boy, you know?
The best lazy boy on the planet.
Oh, yeah, you never want to get up, you know?
All right, here we go. Start of round number two in the second bout, TCB 30 here at the Salisbury Center. Come out and touch gloves. Aimeek be out of the blue corner. Guillermo out of the red corner. They're just right into a clinch.
And it looks like Guillermo's corner said to him, hey, pressure forward, immediately get involved in that clinch because that's where you're having success. And make Aimeek push off, and Aimeek was able to do that there.
Oof. Guillermo just missed him with a big overhand right.
Two good body kicks have now landed for Guillermo. Now, one thing I like from Aimeek here is when he throws that kick, he'll immediately put something in Guillermo's face to prevent that counter.
Wow, that was pretty quick. Good action from like 1, 2, 3, and then bang with the front kick.
Yeah, and that was all off of a response to Aimeek's jab, which I thought was very impressive for Guillermo to throw with that kind of speed.
Good knee from Guillermo. You can see the body of Aimeek getting pounded with those knees. Both guys trying not to get caught.
Got a good elbow there, snuck in.
Yeah, Aimeek really likes those elbows.
Let's see if Aimeek is able. Now, Aimeek was working the clinch there. He's looking to get out of the, there you go, right, out of the clinch. Ooh. Good block there from Guillermo, keeping his hands high.
I like that. Double up on that, Aimeek. As soon as that kick happened, Guillermo blocked it. He put his hands right down. I'd have come right back with that same kick. Oh! Ooh.
It looked like that was a slip, like not a punch.
Correct.
Yeah. Good leg kick there from Guillermo.
Ooh, just missed with the right hand.
Now, I like what Guillermo's doing. He's got great combinations, but he's punching himself into getting jammed up, right? He's taking away his power by punching a little bit too close and then, you know, entering into the clinch when I think sometimes a couple more combinations would be more successful for his game.
All right, into round number two here at TCB 30. Right here with this shot. Looks more like a trip right here as you see this, like you were talking about, Charles, as we just missed it. All right.
Yeah, and you know, these clips, they happen so quick. It's tough for production to be able to capture them. What it looked like was that as Guillermo was throwing that right hand and pressuring forward, Aimeek was already backing up like he was going to take that front foot for a push kick. So as Guillermo closed the distance, he fell back over that heel, which will happen. That's totally normal, you know. And again, it's just bad timing that he fell over as it looked like there was a punch that was occurring. But no, I think both guys here, they have real conflicting styles, with Guillermo being very having a big advantage, I think, in the clinch. Whereas it looks like Aimeek has got the hand advantage, and he's got to let them go. But he looks pretty tired right now, and I'm not sure that's going to happen.
Yeah, Guillermo exerted a lot of energy in that second round. Well, Victor pushes him back. Look, Guillermo's ready to go, though. I like the smile.
Yep, he looks ready to rock.
Keep putting him back there. Start him up, Victor. We're ready to go. They're ready. All right, here we go. Start round number three. Touching gloves, though. Ooh.
Oh, good elbow.
Little front jab, then follow with an elbow for Guillermo.
Like that. Jab, yeah, elbow on the same side.
Yeah,
clean.
I like that.
And this is just very tiring, this position. This fighting in the clinch this way is not easy for anybody.
Trying for those knees. Aimeek got Guillermo tied up just a little bit. Guillermo has all red on, shin guards, tape, except for his gloves, and gray shorts. Both guys just kind of using that head. I know they try to say don't headbutt, but you get in there and you start wiggling around, and it's probably the hardest thing you got.
Yeah. And you drive forward. Good left hook there from Aimeek, but a beautiful slip and leg kick from Guillermo. Some of Guillermo's best kicks actually come as counters, not as a follow-on to his own combination.
Right. Ooh, good right hand from Guillermo. Trying to keep some
good
distance.
Leg kick again.
Trying to keep some distance. Yeah, I'm going to tell you, Aimeek looks really winded right now.
He is. And I think this is where Guillermo could have more success of just keeping him in that corner and just kind of throwing hands and throwing those kicks.
Oh, good right elbow to the left side of the face. Two of them to the left side of Guillermo's face. Another left from Aimeek. Really coming through right after I said he looked tired. He's throwing some good quality blows.
Everything he throws is very crisp. But it does seem like this clinch work is just, it's taken its toll. Now he's starting to get tired. Good knees there from Aimeek.
All right, there it is. The end of round number three.
great fight. It looks like, in my opinion, I think Guillermo Caro is going to be decided the winner here. But that was a really great fight from both guys.
That's going to be a close one for me. I'm going to go, just because you said one way, I think Aymeric actually won 1 and 2.
Really?
Yeah, I do. I think that he stayed enough. He kept busy. I thought that the elbows landed, did some damage. So it's going to be interesting to see. And you know why I just do that? Because to make you look like a rock star, because I usually don't know what I'm talking about.
Well, not for nothing. You provided pretty good analysis as to why you do think that he won that second round. So you actually got me thinking about it a little bit now, you know? Good for you. It seems that after all these years of commentary, my color analysis is starting to wear off on you.
I'm just copying.
Aymeric over there dancing a little bit.
Yeah, you know, they look tired while they're fighting. Why don't you use that energy while you were in there throwing blows?
I think some of that might just be the relief, too.
Yeah. Adrenaline dump. All right. It looks like Chris has the results. Victor will switch sides for the fighters. Chris has it. And let's throw it down to Chris Fuller. We'll get the results right now.
Salisbury Center, after 3 rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. Judge 1 scores about 30-27. Judge 2 scores about 29-28. And Judge 3 scores about 29-28. All in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. Out of the red corner, it's Guillermo Caro.
I'm never right here at either Cadezilla or TCB. TCB 30, when we come back live from the Salisbury Center, we are trucking down the fight card. Don't anybody go anywhere.